Hello, in this video you will see how Sparrow search algorithm is working with MATLAB code. As in previous video, we learn what is this algorithm all about and how it is working step by step with an example. Now we will try to learn how this algorithm is working step by step with MATLAB code. Sparrow search algorithm is inspired by the foraging behavior of bird sparrow. And in sparrow population, we have two type of birds, producer and scavenger. Producer collect food from the different sources and scavenger take food from the producers. You can check everything about this algorithm in this video. Now we will learn how this algorithm is working with the MATLAB code. This is the final output for this algorithm. In the end, we will return the best position and the best fitness value. This is the simple optimization process for this algorithm. Here we will initialize the population for the search agents randomly. After that, we will compute the fitness value for each search agent, and according to their fitness value, we will select the best search agent. After that, we will update their positions in the search space. And we will check if new position is better than before, then we will update it, and again we will compute the fitness value, and after that we will select the best position and fitness value. We will repeat this loop until we met the stopping criteria, and in the end we will return the best position and fitness value. In step 1, we will initialize the population randomly and all the important parameters required. Input is here population size n, maximum of iteration max t, number of producers, alarm value is R2, ST is the safety threshold. Population size is 100. Maximum of iteration is 1000, number of producer is 20, alarm value is generated randomly, so during execution of this code, this value is generated randomly using rand function, and ST is the safety threshold, and for this value is used 0.8. And this is the best position in the minimum fitness value that we will return in the end. Now, using this, we can generate the population randomly. Here, I'm using the fitness function F1. You can check in the search paper. And for fitness function F1, we have lower bound minus 100, upper bound 100, dimension 30. And N is 100, that is the population size. You can see here, this is the population generated for 100 search agents randomly. One is done, that is the initialization of search agents randomly. Now we will compute the fitness value for each search agent. For that you can use any fitness function. And here in the separate file, just create a function. And inside this you can see we have all the important arguments, lower bound, upper bound, dimension. Here we are using switch statement. We can switch the function which one we want to use, either f1, f2, f3 and so on. And you can see here, this one is for function f1 for f2. You write this code like this. We got the minimum fitness value for this, that is 1.0416, and the position is this one. In this step, we will display the current best and current worst sparrow. Here I display only the current best. You have to store the values for current best and current worst, both. Now We will update the sparrow location in the search space. For this, we will use this equation. As in the population, we have producer and scrounger. So first we will update the location for producer. And for this, we will use this equation. Here, R2 is the alarm value. This is the safety threshold. You can check everything in detail in part 1. This is the alarm value that we will generate randomly. And here, this is the safety threshold. And if this condition is true, then we will update position using this equation, else this equation. I provided a link in the description box for the MATLAB code. You can check the link. Now we will update the position for the scroungers. So again, we will check the condition here. If this condition is true, then we will update by this, else this. And this one is for the final update. After that, we will see if the new location that we got is better than before, then we will update it. You can see here, this is the best position. This one is the burst. This is the current. And this is the current fitness value for the individual. This is the burst fitness value for the individual. And this is the global best. So using this, we will update the final position for the each search agent in the search space. And then we will return the best position and the fitness value. You can check the link in the description box for the MATLAB code. And you can see here, every time when you will run the code, you will get the different values. So in this algorithm, just first we will initialize the population randomly, then compute the fitness value for each and store the worst and the best case. After that, update the position, check if the new location is better or not, and return the best position and the fitness value. Every time when you will run the code, you will get the different position, and you can see here. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below. And thanks for watching this video.